at various times in our lives.
Good girl.
Many of us find ourselves searching.
That's a good girl.
Sometimes, intently.
When I found out that I had cancer, they told my family to go ahead and start planning my funeral.
Diagnosed with stage 4 head and neck cancer 3 years ago.
Walk nice.
Then let go from his propane delivery job.
It's almost like it's a nightmare that you can't wake up out of.
Greg Thomas began passing the hours on long walks from his home.
Oh, look at the sun's coming up, Mags.
Alone with his dog and his thoughts.
That sky looked beautiful, huh?
On a gravel road that led him here.
And this is where I would come.
Though Greg would have loved to go inside, the doors on the old Catholic church were locked tight.
I tried it more than once.
Built in 1868 by Czech settlers who later moved to a bigger parish in Montgomery, the church had not been home to a congregation in more than a century.
Really a rough shape.
The foundation was crumbling, the paint peeling, but it was here Greg Thomas, crumbling himself, came to pray. One day.
Did you say your prayers this morning?
The stranger on the steps walked next door.
He went to the neighbor and said he'd like to paint the church. Who does he talk to? So the neighbor sent him to talk to me.
As treasurer of the foundation that keeps up the church cemetery, Don Rinda could barely believe it. Before Greg started work, 3 years back, Don had feared the church's days were numbered.
It was a godsend, yes. No doubt about that.
140 years worth of paint, 15 layers thick in places, came peeling off as Greg worked through the lingering effects of the cancer treatments that robbed him of his energy, his saliva glands, and even his teeth.
I've been on a feeding tube now for 3 years, you know, and This is how I feed myself, you know, with the tube and a syringe.
And this is how Greg feeds himself, too.
That was the first thing I wanted to try when I walked in here, is to see if the bells still worked.
Once inside, Greg found intact an 1860s interior.
It was overwhelming. We desperately need a roof.
A dust-covered museum.
The floors was all rotted out.
In need of his care.
It's going to be beautiful. It really is.
Greg has no family ties to the church, but to those who do.
Grandpa.
Greg has been a blessing. Heaven sent.
One of the beads on my rosary is reserved for him.
If you, like Blanche Zellmer, believe in the power of prayer, this next part will come as no shock.
You can't help but not think otherwise.
The old church is newly clothed in white.
It's what he's done for me.
And Greg's cancer is now in remission.
This is my way of saying thank you.
Greg can pray inside now whenever he wants, but there's something about this concrete pew.
There's been a lot of tears shed on these steps. And they've been tears of joy. Tears of pain. But tears of blessing, too.
Greg Thomas is restoring the old church. That's true. But it's hard to discern who's saving who.
And that's the heart of it.
Boyd Hooper, Care 11 News, Le Sueur County.